mine is not lit. It's not in operation, but I want us to focus on the center. Go from the top to the center. You should see a light shining in there on a steel shaft. So that steel shaft is 65 feet long. It's 38 inches in diameter. It weighs 114 tons. And at its base, it is connected to that Francis type water wheel or turbine. So the water that comes in through the penstocks, that's where we were just at, hits the water wheel at about 48 miles an hour. That's enough force to spin the shaft. That in turn spins the rotor assembly, creating the power. The rotor assembly is the biggest piece of the generator. It weighs in at 560 tons. So you may wonder how we get that out for maintenance. If you take a look at the American flag, it's being proudly displayed off an original to the construction E&H bridge crane. And if you look further down, there's actually a sister. Now, they both travel the length of the room. There's a rail system on the sidewalls. And each crane will lift a 300-ton object. It's not enough for one rotor assembly, so we have to connect the cranes and form a 600-ton capacity. On the floor behind that fence down there is another generator. That is a Pelton water wheel generator. We have two of those. Each one of those produces 2.4 megawatts of electricity, and that's how we run the dam. That is also the very first generator to produce power. It began operating in September of 36. 25 years later, N8 became the last, December 1961. There's another important date there, when we started tours. That would be April 1st, 1937. Hoover Dam was built with all of you in mind. That shows beautifully in the architecture inside and out. An example inside is what you're standing on below is this terrazzo floor. Now it's very labor involved, all done by hand. Tile, and we have 121,000 square feet of it. It was installed in 1936-1937 by Martina Fenn. The cost was like $59,000. Today it would be priceless. Beautiful inlays were done by Alan True. Alan True of Native American art and Western art. The whole concept of Hoover Dam, we wanted to pay tribute to that. He took designs for the Native American Indians. Combined with the Art Deco style, the great images of power, like the one next to me. The circular letter represents a turbine in the water motion. Right, and how many people came to see Hoover Dam? None of you are raising your hand. Look right there. That big concrete wall. Like, at this level, the dam's 450 feet thick. It's solid interlocking blocks of concrete, no structural steel or rebar. And on the other side of all that beautiful concrete's Lake Mead. Now, let's give you a good visual. How thick is the footprint or the base of Hoover Dam? It is 660 feet thick. So if you go from here and you look to the end, that is 650 feet. So this room is 10 feet shy or 3 meters shy of the thickness. So the bottom of the dam.